Okay, here we go.
All right, we're off.
Are they going?
Yeah, they're going. All right. Well, I'll radio drama
is. Yeah. Okay.
They found a torture foresight and a food shop. The food shop has a cheese in it.
Wow, they really didn't wait for me to get things going there, but it's okay. I don't think we actually missed any of the action. We are off and running. I'm going to very quickly change the scores around, so if you want to just kind of keep an eye on everything. All right, 13.
These are the runs you like in early, like early vision and health, and you're just like, yay!
Yeah, Torch Force is so good. Yeah, that's nice. All right, we should be good to go. Everything's running. We got the scores correct. One more layer, and we would have been in limbo. Yeah, we got it. We got it figured out. Holy water's better than Polyphemus. All right, but we are off and running here. Money's on Condor.
Oh,
this is a little spicy for Arboretic there.
He nearly got himself in trouble.
He almost got roasted. Actually, this is kind of scary for Narwhal, too. Nicely handled there. Pulling the dragon horizontally to not get lit up. Very good.
Narwhal can't get his luck because he dropped his beat in there.
So now we have a seeded difference here. Luck versus not luck. Narwhal $3 short.
Oh, what? He conjures the weapon and it's a glass longsword?
Wow, a 1-3. I mean, it is 1-3, but wow, glass longsword. And that is not going to happen for Arboretic. We'll see what Arboretic winds up getting anyway. He's probably going to check this chest.
I don't think he...
Or not.
Yeah.
Not checking the 1-3 chest. That's kind of surprising. I would
especially with luck, because that turns it into a boss chest.
Yeah. So it's essentially, checking your boss chest. It could be anything. Well, not anything, but it could be something good. Instead has to do a very slow fight here. That's a problem. And that's a nice shield scroll for Narwhal.
Spell.
That is a spell. You are correct. Thank you.
And it's an obsidian whip for Arboretic. No!
No, not like this. Blueberry whip. Not so good, Al. And
a really good shot for Ring of Peace and Lead Boots.
Man, it is all about that luck charm. Am I right, people? Except for not at all. We'll see what it looks like for Arboretic if he looks in there. I don't know. We'll see. Is he going to check? He is going to check.
Oh, that is very nice. That's a very nice.
Oh, yeah, not so bad. Not so bad at all.
He can't afford the...
plate.
Oh, he might have to farm.
Farming for the plate? I don't know. I would just take the other thing. You're behind.
Yeah, I think that's what you have to do.
You know you're not getting the plate in the next... I mean, with all the health.
I think the purple chest is too important to pass up on it. It could be really good.
Well, he's passing up on it. Just taking the plate. I don't agree. But we'll see.
No bombs on this seed yet.
That's really advantage nobody. Nobody gets the advantage from that.
Well,
advantage the guy who's in the lead. This is really
Narwhal found the plate mill in his black chest.
Oh my god. Good luck.
He's like, get me off of this glass longsword. And the game's like, nah.
That's crazy. Alrighty.
Okay, so interesting thing about hitting the luck shrine. The Shrine of Chance. Arboretic actually took a hit, so he's not going to get off of this.
He'll have that luck shrine if he can farm up some money, though.
Right, so the interesting thing, if you have any piece of luck, you always pay out. However, if you don't have it, it's random if it pays out, and it's not seeded if it pays out.
Really?
So you could have a situation where two people see the shrine. What comes out of the shrine is seeded, but whether it pays out or not is not. So you can have basically a situation where two people who don't have luck hit a Shrine of Chance, and one person gets like a Ring of Courage, and the other person gets nothing.
Unless they kept playing, but they may like.
Yeah, if they
never
kept playing, yeah. Right. If they kept playing,
the
like,
next item so they will get is the courage, but they just might not ever yes. get it.
Crazy. It might get it on the third play or the fourth play, but it might never get it, exactly.
Whoa.
Yeah, that ended up happening in a Necrobot race where Inknun was like, hey, I got Courage and Chainmail from this, or Courage and Blast Helm. We're like, let's all play it. We're like, I didn't get anything.
That's crazy. Oh, man, I love it.
This is
Rask.
Very slow
shake
for our
turns Shrine of Chance into a very angry affair. This is true. Oh, there's an Obsidian Rapier, though. Pretty solid.
Yes. Again, he's got a holster too. I would probably be still running this glass until I broke it.
Yeah, I think so as well. Although, well, he's got the lead boots. I don't know. Yeah.
If you drop your beat, I think it's good to switch. Like, if you just kind of like drop it before anything else.
Yeah, I could agree with that. It's just Arboretic going slow, Luck Charm not helping him. Because he's got a whip this whole time. I mean,
I mean, who knows? Maybe if he would have checked that black chest. There was a black chest on 1-3?
Yeah.
Was it black?
Yeah. Well,
it might have had that glass longsword.
He didn't see it. It was just, you could see the chest, so.
Oh, okay.
And chest color changes depending on whether you have the charm or not, too, right?
It shuffles around the item pools, and so that can definitely change. Just various things, like opening a barrel can change the chest, too. So, like, if you open a barrel on 1-1 and there's, like, cheese in it, it removes the cheese from the pool. So that means if on 1-2 there was a red chest with cheese in it, it'll change to something else. Which means it could even change to, like, a black chest with an obsidian spear in it or something like that.
Crazy. I mean, that was a really nice 4-2 handle.
Oh, he's going to get chomped a few times.
This is bad. Oh, man. Arboretic is just not having a very good run this time.
Well, he's going to be able to holy water here if he can line it up.
Hard to do sometimes with a cat. Uh-oh. Okay, well, he had to holy water just to not die. Well, that's not true. I think he would have been fine, but decides to holy water there anyways.
He would have been down to, I think, half a heart.
Sketchy. Already a dead ringer. I mean, Narwhal is like a full zone ahead of Arboretic at this point.
Yeah, not as close as we thought this was going to be. I just think the build difference was a bit too much. And
it was substantial.
Arboretic was never comfortable. I don't think he's very comfortable with this cat either.
Previous seasons of Condor with completely different builds, basically. That phasing, though. That is a phasing find in the purple chest.
Yeah, miracle phasing.
Miracle phasing. I mean, he would have had butt puzzle, but he would have been fine.
Like, you're looking for that or the bomb spell. You can blood magic the bomb spell because he's got the health and he's got the chicken.
Yeah.
So that was the other thing he was looking for.
Exactly. GG. Never taking Arboretic. Luck again.
Arboretic just wants this run to be over, so he's just waiting for the dot done so he can just mercy kill
and
this run.
And the dot done has happened. GG. Narwhal wins the first one pretty handily. Congrats, Narwhal. Takes a victory. And this race I'm sure will start up again real quick. All right.
If the Arboretic doesn't know that it's over, or he did just die.
Yeah, okay. I'm not sure. He did die to a spider there. I'm not sure if he was maybe just trying to, like, finish the run. Being a zone back, though, not exactly good for him to try and finish the run.
That run felt so gross. I don't think he felt comfortable at all as soon as he got that obsidian weapon.
Yeah, it was just not.
That run was just over, and he just couldn't in that run. He was just like, you know what? This is so bad. I just can't even do anything.
And I don't blame Arboretic. It's just a crappy everything. Never got really off that weapon. I mean, he definitely should have checked that chest. What can you do?
Might not have even been a black chest. I mean, there's only like a 1-in-3 chance it's black.
That's true.
Well, I don't know. I don't know if it generates a 1-in-3 chance or if it just puts an item there and then it gives you the appropriate chest. That's interesting.
I don't know. All right, we're off. Arboretic and Narwhal. Match 2.
Now we're home the wrong way, so he resets.
The old quick reset. This looks like the U-shaped layout.
Oh, Arboretic took a chomp. He decided to hit a skeleton instead of a ghost. That's wrong.
I feel like Narwhal might have been able to scoot through there. if he'd just kind of tried to break through the right wall. And he actually would have been done this way faster.
Maybe. It's
could have been,
yeah, depends if there's a secret room or if there's like a... Oh, that's a really good shot, but you gotta throw for it.
Gotta throw
okay,
for
he's
it.
Got it. He's
Here's
got it.
Here's where some RNG really kicks in. And
what I
Narwhal
probably,
doesn't. He just pushes.
What I probably do is I buy the free spell, then I throw.
Yeah.
You can guarantee yourself.
That's true. Interesting. So now the only real difference here is Blood Drum and a heart and a half for Arboretic over Narwhal, but Narwhal's got a little bit more speed. Not a ton, though, and he just had to risk that red bat, which was super sketchy. He could have frozen, maybe? Or no, he's froze. His freeze is on cooldown, so I'm not sure.
The problem is, they both just froze that trap door, and then neither of them are going to be able to freeze
Coral Rift
fight, and they don't have a bomb.
Oh, no.
Oh, this is like a 45-second fight. Like,
yeah, it's going to take forever.
45 seconds. Minute 30, walking in.
Sorry, I was trying to console my dog who was freaking out. I mean, you could. Well, he's got the bomb throw now, Arboretic does.
Oh, yeah, Arboretic does have bombs. That's interesting.
And he could bomb Blood Drum if he wanted to do it the wrong way. Yeah, this fight is taking ages.
Yeah, we're
Total
at 30 seconds
RNG
for
that boss.
30 seconds for Narwhal, and he's going to throw here. So, yeah, that was a 40-second fight.
Yikes.
Or a 35-second fight, and he always gonna get himself his Obsidian Flail.
Yeah. Little trauma there for Arboretic, maybe, with the Obsidian not the best weapons, but Obsidian Flail's alright. He can push pretty hard
I really like it. I think it's probably the safest of the weapons he could have right now, and you can find food with it because it's got 3 damage.
Little role reversal here. Arboretic skipping the Lucky Charm and Narwhal taking it from that same boss. Interesting.
You'd think Narwhal wouldn't take it after how it
totally,
kind of
yeah, worked out for him.
Got him the win, yeah.
It makes total sense, Arboretic not taking it. But I mean, it sometimes works out, sometimes it doesn't. It just really didn't work out last time at all.
Oh, really wanting this, this barrel... Is...
Yeah, that could have some food in it. Could be delicious. Could also be pain.
Oh, he broke his multiplier, but it is food.
Oh, so it is. Cheese.
He's leaving the Blood Drum. Don't leave the Blood Drum.
What?
Okay, he's going back to the Blood Drum.
Get that. Get it. And our next boss is Konga, and Narwhal is ahead. After a disastrous Corriff, doing a slow... he has to do the slow.
Blast Helm. He didn't find the Blast Helm. because he took luck. He took luck.
That's true. Did he get a glass torch instead of a blast?
Mm-hmm.
Man,
certainly
luck
looks like
has
it.
Been screwing over our racers today. There's a bomb spell, I guess.
Yeah, certainly. It's probably gonna be like a ring of courage.
Yeah, with the flail too. Oh my god, this is ridiculous.
I don't know, it might be a Ripage Scroll, who knows. But if it is a good ring, it could kind of very well catch him up.
Well, he's really not that far back. He's just a couple floors, and the spooky build right now for Narwhal means
it was a really good ring. Oh no, and he can't get to that trapdoor in time for the ice elemental to hit it.
Wait, what happened? It was.
He found phasing, but he didn't take it. It was phasing, but he didn't take it.
Interesting.
Oh, what a shop!
Hey, that's all right. A holster with a jeweled dagger is pretty good find.
Maybe should have bought that ring.
Bought the ring first, though. I mean, why not? Kill in the shop, Narwhal. Get himself some heavy plate, so he's in a lot safer of a situation than he was prior.
And the boots means he can run the flail.
Exactly.
He can run
the
flail on
him. Yeah, because the flail is real dangerous if you don't have the boots going into zone 4. But now he's in a much safer situation, though. Questionable direction on attacking this dragon. Look out. Seems like he's gonna
Managed
be fine.
It.
Yeah, handles it. Yeah, Luck is being a bit of a punk right now. Using freeze, got it. Narwhal, very nice. The only thing, the good luck there, is that we see another Shrine of Chance, but Narwhal completely missing it, and our, just like last time, our racer with the luck misses it, and our racer without luck gets it. And there goes the Leprechaun, so we are seeing no luck on our Arbretic side. No luck. And that is not a food shop. Wow, this is like a crazy... I mean, Narwhal is way ahead again. I don't know, maybe Narwhal's just got the scoots? He's got the scoots in him today.
So Narwhal found that glass shovel.
Yeah.
Which means, so with the bomb spell, what he can do, if he holds onto this glass shovel, he'll be able to dig the middle turnip, kill it, and then he can bomb with the bomb spell and then blood bomb again to free the lore. To free the loot, I mean.
Or, so if you, you could do the, if you have enough health for three bombs... Which he won't.
Yeah,
right
you
now.
Can do.
You can do the
three.
Dig out and get the free hit, but I don't know if that's gonna happen.
You would need another heart to be able to pull it off.
Yeah, but you're right.
Or some kind of
this
some
situation,
kind of food between.
Yeah, this current situation. Oh, there was three bombs behind that wall. I don't know if you saw it.
Well, now he can just. You can do spawn minimization and then dig the last.
For the one of the faster starts for your Necrodancer fight. Just got to be a little careful. I mean, he does have heavy plate, but otherwise he's in pretty decent shape. He did swap away from the flail, even though, you know, he could run it. But, oh, careful. Spooky Ghost handles it.
It could make Deadringer a little... It's unconventional. They're strats and they're safe, but you have to learn them. Oh, he took a hit there. He took another hit there because of his...
Glass...
Losing his multiplier. So if he had the flail there, it'd have been fine.
Yeah. Yeah, an obsidian flail isn't as bad as an obsidian other weapons because you can maintain. And we're using some jeweled dagger action, which is smart for Arboretic. I mean, you get hung up on less stuff and you one-shot golems, so it's smart. And he's actually doing 6 damage. But he's just so far behind right now. I don't know. Even butt puzzles, and I think Narwhal would be...
Oh, Narwhal, what are you doing? I think you're going to kill yourself.
That spawn is bad. That spawn is bad. Oh,
so,
no.
Okay. So if you're going to do the Japanese strat, which is hit the bottom left bell, bottom right, and then the top right bell, if you have to waste a beat, you can't hit from the bottom. So normally you want to hit from the bottom of the top right bell. But if things go wrong, or like a skeleton is blocking your way... You need to go and hit it from the left of the top right bell.
Gotcha.
This moves the ogre. So otherwise, what happens is the ogre blocks you off from being able to move,
definitely,
and you can't, and you get trapped with the ringer.
Oh.
So you hit it from the left, and then you have to like move up or left depending. Sometimes the ogre spawns to the right of the bell, and then he's ready to hit you right away. It's spooky. But in this situation, when you're this far ahead, you have to lure.
Yeah. There was no reason for him to do those risky strats.
Oh,
that
and he
freeze.
Just...
Oh! Wait, what? Oh,
okay,
because
he
attacked him on the bead he unfroze on. That's...
Mm-hmm. So what ends up happening is, freezing... So when you freeze your a teleporting enemy, they don't teleport when you hit them, but they unfreeze between you hitting them and them hitting you.
And then they hit you.
So you have... So what you have to do is when they get the flash, you have to back off.
That is such an edge case. That sucks so hard.
Yeah,
oh, man.
But that's something you have to learn. But that's something you never forget once it happens.
Yeah, I got the animation, Ron. It just took me a sec. All right, we're seeing the fast
attack. Oh, we're gonna same thing's gonna happen for.
Oh God! Don't not like this! Not like this! Not like
exact
the wind
same
spell.
Thing is happening.
Oh my God!
Wind spell.
Okay, get to kill that ogre.
So
no.
So spooky right now. It's so. Oh no!
This is something that Blue Blimp preaches, and I'm 100%. If you are ahead, there is no reason to do the Japanese strat. Just lure. Just do the safest strat possible.
Oh my God, I can't believe it. Well, we've got a seeded race now where they both know the seed. And it's pretty close. They're both still in zone one. So who's got the best memory now? Who is it? Oh my god. And see, yeah, the 1-1, we're seeing Arboretic sneak through the top, like I mentioned.
Oh, but Arboretic should have used that purple scroll.
Oh, should have used Gigantism.
Would have saved him. Mm-hmm. Yeah, would have saved him the...
He would have had the bomb for this kill. He could Giganticism here. I guess
it would speed
really
it up
matter.
A little bit. He's probably going to hold on to it for...
Yeah, he got a good spawn.
Let's see. First thing's Core Rift. That's the other thing. First thing's Core Rift, so you want to have your freeze up for it.
Yeah, or take the broadsword with the Giganticism. That'll get you through Core Rift nice and easy. And, well, yeah, keep the freeze up. That's the other way to do it.
Yeah, he froze last time on this. Oh, but remember, there's bombs. Remember he found
bombs
last time.
Oh, there are bombs, yeah. That's true. Oh, my God. Yeah, sorry, the cadence kind of flashed up on the screen there. I did not intend for that to happen. But it did. Another opportunity if you want to take luck early and see if you get something better than Obsidian Flail. But Obsidian Flail is really not that bad moving into zone 2.
I would consider getting luck here. Just
for Arboretic?
Yeah, just to see if you get something. Oh, he didn't have the multiplier.
It might be worth the risk because he might get something amazing that'll allow him to catch up considering he's, you know, 2 floors back or whatever. And he didn't keep the freeze up again. Maybe it's worth just blood freeze.
He didn't find his bombs either.
Oh, Arboretic, why? I think he...
It is definitely worth the blood freeze.
I think Narwhal was the one who found the bombs last time, right?
No, it was definitely it was Arboretic. Narwhal was the one with the 42nd.
Roll reversal. What the what?
Now, this is when you prep... Oh, he freezes here.
Okay.
What you should have done, if the freeze wasn't up, you could have blood drum and then thrown, and it would have worked.
Would it have?
But he's a full... Yes.
The like, blood drum you throw prep, kills prep. Insta? I thought it would just teleport what? Him.
Well, no, after you've done the entire thing and he becomes active.
Okay. And that's...
So, Narwhal took phasing. I don't think that's a really smart idea. You're ahead of zone and you have no health and you don't have no torch.
With the risk of the bisque.
Sir, don't take phasing. Right, he needs to...
Okay, maybe... That... Maybe in that...
No, case. 2 pieces of food? Okay.
Oh, God.
This is where you drain your...
I would take the blood shove. Might as well. You never know. It could be useful if you go off phasing, right?
I think you drain your entire owl.
Your coin on the chance?
And then you bomb it, too. Because bombing, it gives you a guaranteed item.
Yeah.
But owl, he took 2 hits there. And...
Yeah. Both of our racers are at 1.5. This is ridiculous, this race. I don't think there's a transmute anywhere nearby, so probably not going for that ring.
No.
And some phasing strats here. A little squeaky.
There was a conjurer on, like, 4-1, but
yeah,
it was
on the unzone 4, but I don't know where the transmute shop was. Nobody going... Oh, no, Arboretic's got luck now. Again, they swapped luck. Because Narwhal had luck last race. This is crazy. By the way, the timer is angry.
It's...
My timer gets mad when it's... And he doesn't get it. He gets a pickaxe. Oh,
man. He shouldn't take it. He shouldn't take it. Because if he gets off of his...
Sorry about that. I'm dying. I'm okay.
Now if he gets off his ring, he can't blood drum dig the stage.
Yep. Things are bad. Narwhal going full meme here. And
just take the quick roll.
That'll save you from the dead ringer. Dead Ringer dunked twice. Man, this race is ridiculous. I love it. It's so long, but I love it.
If he could find a potion, then he'd be 100% perfect because then he could blood freeze. But that's what you're looking for, really. Oh,
yeah.
That's the Conjurer. He knows. That's the wrong torch. You don't want that torch. That's the torch you want.
There you
good.
Go. He's good.
And Arboretic went down to a Fire Slime.
Oh, Fire Slime. Yeah, they get you sometimes. That's too bad. Arboretic had this one in the bag. And he ends up getting dunked on Dead Ringer, and then a Fire Slime takes him down. Oh, he was in a real bad spot, actually. I wish I had, I didn't quite have the timing up for that, but hello. Careful. Interesting. Killing the shopkeeper there.
Now,
the shopkeeper ghost on the 4-3.
The good thing is now that he's got... he has 7 bombs in his blast zone. He only has to keep 1. So he
can
actually
can
just kind
it.
Of...
And he can also jump into that Goblin Bomber. Careful, don't get in the walls. Oh, okay, he saw it in time. That could have been bad.
That so he's got the freeze. The he's got 7 bombs. He can bomb. Yeah, he's got the Quakeswirl for Dead Ringer.
Yeah, and now a ring of gold. I might want to take that back. And you got to be careful
freeze,
with that flail.
Have...
Yep. For the, I guess you don't take damage though, because he's got the blast helm. But for the pixies. All right, Dead Ringer. Let's see if he does the exact same thing or if he uses his quake.
He's
scoping not
using
it out
his
again.
Why the... No, he forgot about his quake.
Oh,
he's trying
Narwhal.
To run now.
Why? Not like this. Although he's doing some very nice flail strats here. I gotta
he
say.
He got it. He did get
oh,
it.
That was
he did
beautiful.
Get the lure with the flail.
Very
and,
nice
oh,
flail
no,
strats.
He screwed it up. He's...
Oh my god. What is happening? What is happening? Oh my god, I can't believe it. What is this life? Quakeswirl! Oh my god. Golf clap.
I'm speechless.
Oh, the chalking indeed, Chaotic Magnet. The chalking indeed. Holy crap. I mean...
That's probably a situation where you think so hard. He's probably thinking so hard, I can't screw up this Dead Ringer. I have a flail. I have flail-specific strats that he just forgets he has the Quakeswirl.
Yeah. Oh, so who do we give the kill to on that? The flail or just Dead Ringer? I think Dead Ringer's 3-0 right now. This is ridiculous.
Yeah.
I love it. Guys, we're getting our money's worth today. And there's that 1-3 1-3 chess with thing it was actually a torch. Oh, and there's a phasing shrine there. Interesting. So you can get early phasing in this build. Oh, and
oh,
I
no!
found where the bombs are. Oh, missed on the
Arboretic
bomb!
Messed up his bomb! Aquarius
is
the reason!
I mean, he could have maybe made it. No, he only had a heart. The early bomb. The palms are sweaty, folks. Knees weak. Mom's spaghetti. Oh, man. I can't even believe what's going on right now.
This
and it's up to
the
Narwhal to win it again. Narwhal's got the chance. Will he miss his chance to blow? Using that Giganticism scroll. Keep your bomb. Giganticism into that. Please. Oh, Discord's down. Uh-oh. That's not good. Ravioli all over your face. Everywhere. This is craziness. Oh, man. This is definitely a situation now where both of these racers, who are seasoned veterans, are just in full panic mode. I feel like they just don't know what to do.
I feel like if you die twice, okay, Arboretic just blood drop to try to kill the dragon, and then he missed it.
No, Arboretic, get out of there. Oh, man.
At a certain point, he is not, like, handled any of these trapdoors well. He's usually freezing on them. He's usually taking damage. Like, it's okay. It's fine.
I feel bad that there's still another race for these two after this. Because I feel like they're just going to be exhausted after this race. I mean, it's such a slugfest. And I mean slug in both sense of the term.
I mean, if you die on Dead Ringer twice, you're just like...
You gotta keep going, though. This is just your
I
life
know.
Now. This seed. Wasn't this the seed Rat said was the really dangerous seed? It's because, like, the demonic Dead Ringer was on this seed. All right, Arboretic, use the Giganticism scroll to dig. Dang it. Didn't do it. Oh, and that
Giganticism
slip and slide out of the shop.
Why would you use the purple scroll before you throw instead of digging into it and then using the purple scroll and then throwing anyway? Like,
yeah,
either way, you have it.
You have it. All right, Iberic, right here. Purple scroll. Oh, he doesn't even have it anymore.
He doesn't even get the purple scroll this time.
He just wants to get this kill. Oh, God, this is heartbreaking.
Okay, Death Metal 3.
Here we go. I mean, it's a pretty good build.
He's got a freeze, so it's going to be fine.
He's got freeze. There's the blood drum. I mean, with the blood drum, you can kill Dead Ringer pretty easily, right, guys?
Maybe he'll find the Quake Scroll and remember it this time. A shield spell. That's good. This way, if it goes off the rails.
Yep, you can pop that
shield. If it goes off the rails, you can just pop the shield and you're fine.
This is actually a pretty fast time for Narwhal right now. He's going pretty quick.
I would hope so. He's gotten here three times already.
Oh my god, this run is great.
Third run, you better be fast.
Oh.
You know where everything is now.
This actually...
Oh, he just got hit by the ogre.
It's ogre, folks.
And he has to shield. He has to shield because he couldn't get away from that bomb.
Honestly, the flail has been our racer's worst enemy this game. The flail has been putting... Like, the flail got Arboretic killed in zone 3 when he died to the fire slime. That was 100% the flail.
Okay, so he's actually going to go ahead... And switch to
the spear.
An obsidian spear.
Good idea. Don't accidentally pick up that ring. That would have been amazing.
Oh, he doesn't know what to do with this bounce trap because he's not bouncing.
Perry Knight is just fancy dancing now. Oh,
he's doing another Blade Master.
these Blade Masters are just so crazy. Iberic using a different strat there. It's a fairly safe one, where you leave and then come back. Grab your dagger. All right, Iberic now is his run off and running. Careful. He got him. He remembered what he had. If he still had the flail, he would be dead right now. I mean, there's not a lot of health ups.
Yeah, they didn't find the food shop or anything.
So that's not really helping the situation. We do see Narwhal does not have a torch because he broke it. Well, he didn't break it.
I mean, there was a double heart container in 4-2 in that shop, but he didn't bother going for
empty
it. He could
full?
Have actually... Double full, that's what he killed for last time. He could have killed this time by just blood drum throwing.
Yeah.
And it would
worth
have
it.
Basically
yeah, you'd get
been,
a heart
yeah.
and a half up. All right, Dead Ringer, here we go. We got this team. We're all in this together, chat. Let's go.
Just lure, don't blood drum. You need your blood drum for the Necrodancer fight.
Well, he could butt puzzle, but actually, yeah, the blood drum strats are safer than butt
puzzle.
Well,
he can bomb one, and then he can blood drum the rest out.
Good, nice, and yes! The crowd rises to their feet. Dead Ringer has been slayed.
He's gonna butt puzzle. I think the best thing to do would be to do... Maybe do two, and then he can...
And then dig both sides.
Well, he can bomb out the loot. Oh, he could...
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, so he can bomb the loot out and then just dig...
Hey, the freeze spell is used to kill Deadringer. Or Coral Rift, I mean. Look out.
No. I guess he just doesn't want to spend any health at all.
Bomb and dig.
He doesn't want to spend health at all.
I guess that's kind of fair. This race... is going on 24 minutes.
Okay, he got the shield off, so...
But Dorian takes a hit. I mean, it's only half a heart. Dorian's okay right now. Yeah, he did get the infinite
shield. Dorian's taking another hit.
Oh, please,
Dorian's down to one.
No.
Two and a half hearts.
No.
This can't happen. This can't happen. This race cannot go on. You have to end it. You have to end it.
Keep Dorian like the baby elephant inside the other elephants. Just hidden, safe. There you go. Safety strats to the extreme. Look at that shield. It's so glorious.
Yeah, I much prefer hitting... Yeah, because he did the butt puzzle. The shield lasts forever. I much prefer... Would prefer doing the blood drum. Oh, but we're done. I think we're done. We're going to get
folks.
This done.
Ladies and gentlemen, sub 25 minutes. Narwhal takes it after a marathon race. Oh my god, that was awesome. That was actually fantastic. I really enjoyed that. BGs all around. we did it.
Don't don't submit this to the GDQ reel.
Please, no.
If we're going to do a seated race, here's what it looks like.
Yeah.
We're going to need about 25 minutes, and here's why.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Sub 25, though, folks. Whew. That's definitely enough time for two races normally. We got an ah, that game from Arboretic, and a that was terrible F-word flails from Narwhal. Bam.
Yeah, flail flails.
Flail fails. Oh, man. Oh, no, and then it's this seed. 1241391.
Oh, not this one.
Not
I did this one the other day.
Seed, yeah. But we did get some good luck, have funs, and a U2 from Arboretic. Here goes. It'd be an easy $1,000 for AGDQ.
How many kills will Dead Ringer get? Every time Dead Ringer kills you, you donate $100 in money. Like Woodwix when he runs Bashi.
Yeah, I love that. I think he said, though, he is never going to run Bashi ever again. Whether that's the case or not, we'll see. Sad about that, but that's okay. I'll get over it. Let's go. All right, let's hope that this is just a nice, friendly seed where things are just friendly and good. See what this blood shop has in store.
Oh, you have to take
it. Oh, yeah.
Pop it. Pop it now. Pop it now.
Yeah, you could
get that's fine. That's fine. Titanium cool. Dagger. That's good.
Yeah, Titanium what
you
Dagger.
Could, what you could do instead
did
is
Arboretic
like...
Did decide to keep the bomb?
Yeah, I think he did.
Okay. Yeah,
what
I
you
like
could
that.
Do is you could, I think it's based on when you pop it. So if you're not happy with titanium, you can reset it, pick it up, and then
so
do it
get
again.
Yourself a jewel
like do it on 1-2, and then try to get jeweled or phasing or even frost dagger, which is a really great weapon.
Mm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Hey, I won a necrobot race. Everyone, bomb the Shrine of Peace. I took it. Got a jewel. Got a dagger of frost. Found courage, and I beat everyone.
I can see
with
how it'd
be dagger
good with
of frost. It's basically a worse dagger of phasing when you have courage.
Yeah, it's the piercing that makes it pretty good. I feel like, well, it's honestly, it's not that bad. It's just it's so rare and it's kind of clunky if you're not used to it. So you have to have like 2 grand hours into this game before. All right, Narwhal, what you got? There you go. You're all right.
I don't agree with these guys running phasing.
You know, because
you just had a 25-minute run. Don't run the phasing.
All right, it's okay. We got some food. Arboretic's tanking up. I like it.
Narwhal.
He's got 7 hearts. Narwhal said half a heart.
He face-planted into a queen. He just jumped right into her.
Narwhal, please. His
so
little,
not,
horn
not only is he
on
not
going to
get a torch,
hurt.
He's not going
to... Yeah, he's not going to have a torch. Oh God!
There goes
and
all of the
health.
Food, all of the health that Arboretic just had
please.
Is gone. He's in a bad situation. He doesn't know how to deal with this.
You gotta just
he has
jump
to hit.
Over.
He has
yeah,
to...
there you go. Okay, he's doing the same.
No! Just let him hit.
Just
see
stand
if,
there.
If you don't know how.
Oh boy!
If you don't know how to deal with the Minotaur right there, this
yeah,
means
you
don't
watch,
take phasing.
Watch more Spooty, because this
right.
is like yeah, basic Minotaur handling with phasing. Just stand next to him in the wall and then dunk him in the face. Okay, well, both of our racers are still alive.
No bomb. Oh, there's a bomb. You have to check that cracked wall. It could be a conjurer. That's going to get you your torch.
All right, this Deep Blues is way off the rails already. Lots of wasted beats. That's one of the big issues if you're just starting out this game. If you spend too much... you got it. Spend too much time on Deep Blues, you're gonna have a lot of queens in your hair, and it's not so good. But he did flawless it, so we'll see what he ends up getting. Is he gonna go for a torch or a weapon?
Oh my God.
And he goes for a weapon! Oh God. I don't know. I mean, I can see the maybe, because.
And down goes.
No.
Narwhal.
Narwhal all down. Right. I mean, that half a heart with phasing, so spooky. And he basically just jumped into an armadillo. Is that what happened? No, he jumped into a skeleton. He couldn't even see.
Yeah, that's going to happen.
Okay, he's got to open that cracked wall. I would actually pull one of the golems into that cracked wall to open it. Because it could be a conjure, and you could get yourself...
There's a bomb if he finds it. It's in that little there? Room. Yeah, that room to the south.
The other thing is, if you have phasing and no torch, and you're at half a heart, just don't use the phasing. Just run the level normally. Pretend you don't even have a shovel.
It kind of sucks for Zone 2, though. Cause,
it
like,
super
that's
sucks for Zone
is.
2, but you know what sucks more? Dying.
And then... Oh. Honestly, you know what? Just die, and then get a luck charm, and don't take phasing, and get a weapon that isn't a blood rapier, and you'll be fine. Watch it be a blood
you hear that, folks?
I don't know.
The advice from Jack is just die.
Take the miner's cap. Just please take the miner's cap.
Yeah, yeah.
It's gonna save you. It's gonna save you from the... Okay, he
don't
did
take
it.
The jaw. Don't take the jaw. Okay. It's a bit of a meme, but hey, it gives you vision. This is where you got miner's cap plus phasing, so you've still got your quick kill on the Necrodancer. Like, it's still good.
Oh, no!
The bomb! He double bombed with the bomb! With the bang, the bang!
I've never seen that! I've never seen anybody do that!
Yeah, I've done that. That bomb trap plants a bomb every time you land on it. So if you double tap that bomb trap... Oh my god.
But it's fine. He was fine, and then he jumped back into the second bomb.
Yeah, he needed to jump away. Oh,
he was still
man.
Fine. He would have been at like half a heart, which is still okay because you got the blood rapier.
Oh man.
Narwhal took phasing again. Why?
He got the flawless though. With the titanium dagger.
It's a torch! Hallelujah.
We did it! Ladies and gentlemen, we did it. Mission accomplished. All right. It would have been a good opportunity to test your theory on the enchanted scroll there with the dagger.
Yeah.
That would have been a good time.
Oh, right. If you know phasing is there, maybe you hold on to it.
Yeah, maybe
if
you
can, like. Yeah. It's a Shriner in there, and the Shriner has Oh. Okay. That is such, it would be so tempting to fight it to get a map there, but you really can't.
No, you're ahead.
You really
just
can't.
Please, just do it. Alright, okay. Still not a great build. He's at a heart and a half. Titanium dagger. Arboretic wisely taking the health. Hopefully he'll keep it a little better this time. I don't want to be mean to these racers. It's been a bit of a crazy build. Here's the, there you can now see the... This is actually a pretty ugly 2-3 exit. Especially with only 2 damage. He's handling it very nicely, just don't get stomped on by a dirt golem. It's still so spooky right now, because a lot of things will kill him. He has no armor, he's at a heart and a half.
Well, this is a nice boss for him.
Good boss to get, absolutely. He's got it. Very nice. And what's he gonna go for? What do you go for, a weapon?
I'm assuming a weapon.
And, ooh, Obsidian Broad, very nice.
It's okay, like,
taking more damage again.
Yeah, he kind of jumped into the Minotaur. I would save up money and get... No, not the key. I'd save up money and get the cat.
What was it, a Titanium Cat?
Oh, never mind. Never mind.
Oh, there you go. Titanium Rapier, that's nice. Nice safe-ish weapon.
Yeah.
He's also got the Blast Helm, which is okay. It's not as good because he's got phasing, but it's good. It's
yeah,
safe.
There's certain... Having a lot of it means it's better. Than
yeah, 8 bombs is good.
If you only have, like, 2 bombs, it's not super good with phasing, because it like, opens all the walls around you, and, like, it can be kind of bad. But if you have 8 bombs, which you can just kind of, like, stand there and just be like, hey,
oh
I'm going to, like, stand next
so,
to this dragon and bomb a bunch of times.
Luck... Black chest boss, zone 1 boss, was an Obsidian Rapier this whole time.
See? That's what I'm saying. Like, if you just take the luck once you see that it's bad the first time,
yeah.
You're fine.
There you go. See, luck's not all bad, guys. Don't fuel your confirmation bias.
And down goes Narwhal to
God.
A Yeti.
I
gotta think Arboretic has a really good chance here because he didn't take phasing this time.
He just needs to get a little health regen. Ring a regen, maybe even a heal spell.
There was a Blood Shrine in Zone 3.
There was a Blood Shrine, that is true. And he's got 4 Baums. See, there's where, again, Narwhal could test the thing. I don't know if he knows that, though. about trying for.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if it is based on the level or if it is just based on like which weapon you use it on, or maybe if it's seated. I don't know. Well, I mean, we could check personally.
Yeah, it'd be good to try out.
Oh, that's a very. There's boots.
Hey,
in
nice
this,
boots. It's funny. I see those boots, and I'm like, well, I don't know. Those might be explorer's boots. They might be ballet. But of course, that's just me and my stupid thing. Anyway.
There's a coupon.
Definitely explore. Oh, good. So if he wants to go back and buy the stuff that he could have already bought, he can do it for free now. Oh, this song is so good. The, who is this? It's, yeah, this is the Synthwave 2-3 with the shaker. Oh.
Oh, man, I love
it. It's so good when that shaker kicks in. It's like, could you have picked a better instrument? Shaker, man.
Yeah, Norwalk takes phasing again. He knows that the torch is there, so I guess it's okay.
Yeah.
But it just seems... It seems so kind of silly. Like, at this point, you don't need the torch for zone one because you know how to do it.
Yeah, he knows exactly where it's is. Glassjaw meme cap blood shovel build? You've got it shrouded. Oh my goodness. I honestly, like, I know this looks really bad for these racers. Obviously, there are mistakes to be had, but it's one thing I just need to make sure I point out that racing is not easy. And when things start to go bad, it makes it so much harder. And so do keep that in mind. Don't be too harsh on these racers, because it's rough. It's real rough.
I think this is a case where I was kind of ragging on all for taking the phasing before. I think now you do have to take it, because you're sufficiently behind. And that's the only chance you have to catch up. And totally it's better now that you know that there's a torch there and you can.
Still got that crappy weapon though, comparatively.
He knows where to find a decent weapon though, because he gets that titanium reaper.
Phasing
in 3-1, I
think. That's true, yeah. Oh, and that ring of regen was picked up for Arboretic. And he does have some armor too, so things are looking a little brighter. Here comes 3-3. Oh, this is gross. This is not a nice
super
three-three.
Gross.
Oh
yeah,
my god.
Kill
ugh.
The Yetis. That's fine.
Start killing things. I remember when the bombs are not a smart play. But yeah, when I started to learn about Zone 3 swarms before they got totally nerfed, the key was to kill things, not to run away, because all you do is just aggro more stuff. That is a sloppy floor. Lots of ice and fire everywhere. Yeah, kill things as much as you can, especially if you have a rapier.
I think if you're Narwhal, you don't check the black chest, you go for the purple chest now. If he remembers that there's a titanium.
That's true.
No, yeah. He doesn't remember.
Yeah. He picks up that same obsidian broadsword he got last time.
There's
good weapon.
But
it might be something worth keeping over titanium broad long or rapier, no?
I don't think so. I think you can drop your bead a lot in the wall.
That's a good point.
He's not going to see it, though. Or he's deliberately passing it up.
Needs, like,
maybe
five
he wants
elementals.
Maybe he wants to keep the 3 damage to open crates or something.
Yeah. I mean, that's a good way to help yourself survive. He can also get himself a blood mop. Which would be actually pretty good for safety. I mean, Blood Mop is one of the safest builds you can have, I feel.
Marl just transmuted the scroll with E. He doesn't have a shovel. He could have gotten a shovel, or he could have held on to it for...
Here's that 3-3 for Narwhal. It is gross! And, he got sniped!
I can't really blame him for just trying to push really hard. But...
Yeah, I really...
He had caught up. He had nearly caught up.
Yeah,
and
he was
going to pass. He was going to pass.
Yeah, because phasing zone 4 is really strong. Right now, Arboretic does not have a super safe final boss build. I mean, he's got a lot of health, which is great, but he's only got 3 bombs unless... I know he can blood bomb to keep the turn up on the stage. He might want to do that. Oh, big dino damage there.
Yeah. Damage. He kind of panic bombed and he opened the Batcave.
That's bad. That's not gonna help your panic any. Oh my god. They're eating
him.
Yeah,
he actually got hit again by... He got hit three times by that armadillo.
Oh, that armadillo is a punk. I have an emote exactly for that. The dino damage. Oh, this is quite the matchup, I have to say. I really hope that the fact that we didn't push these guys early caused this.
Hopefully
really
we won't have the 25 minute match.
Yeah.
He's bombing again.
The panic bombs. What's going on?
Yeah.
Do you think those are panic
bombs? He just...
Come on, Arboretic, hang in there, dude. Okay, he's on Dead Ringer. He's only got 3.5 hearts. I don't know if that would save him from a Dead Ringer dunk. Oh, and he's just marching in here. He's just going full. Okay, this is where you start clearing out. Just clear enemies out of here. Just don't honk any bells. Just clear enemies. Yeah, clear the sarcophagi while you're at it. Oh, God.
He's got the mini honk.
Oh, he got punched. I'm so nervous.
please, he's got it.
Left, please. Yes. Oh. Okay, he's got a heal. No potion.
He can blood bomb,
but it'll be at half a heart. Then he'll have a ton of damage with his risk charm.
He's got a butt puzzle. Okay, just do two, and then you can bomb.
Butt puzzles are risky. Yeah, you can
keep...
Because, like, he's bombing those skellies off the stage. So... Oh, wait. No, that's fine. Yeah, I guess you can't really avoid hitting either a turnip or a skeleton off there with those bombs.
Right.
And he can't really move the Necrodancer out of the way.
Oh, he got hit, and then the Necrodancer bombed a skeleton off the stage.
This is going to be sketch now. Only two mini enemies on the stage, so this is pretty much max spawn, I think. Oh god, I am really, really nervous right now. I mean, Dorian having a flail could be good, could also be really bad. We will find out. The confused.
Got three hits left, two hits left actually.
Two hits left, yep. Come on, Arboretic, you got this, dude. Everyone's here, we're all cheering you on. Come on, man.
Dorian
takes a hit. He's got the lure.
There's a red dragon!
Bombing!
Panic bomb!
The panic bomb! He's gotta have that bomb button. He did it! Yes!
Wow!
Oh my god! Oh, heavens to Betsy! Oh, season 4 champion stopping by. Oh man. I think we gotta give some GGs to our friends Arboretic and Narwhal Man. That was a fantastic